The roof had leaked. The walls were damp. The wetness behind the paintings could be more disastrous than the dirt on the front of them. The fresco is coming off the back wall. Bruno Baratti has to get behind the surface. An injection of plastic to bind the painting to the wall. The dampness behind the wall has leaked chemicals on the face. Acid is eating away Michelangelo's art. Fresco painting is the most sturdy and long-lasting of all paint media. Sooner or later, most oil paintings crack. Wood warps. Watercolors fade. But because fresco is wet paint placed into wet plaster, when it dries, there's a chemical bond that makes the painting part of the wall itself. In Italian, fresco means fresh. This is fresh plaster being applied to a section of the wall that couldn't be restored. A painter's assistant would have prepared the plaster for the artist. Paint and wall dry together. The master had to guess how much wall surface he could paint in one day, one giornata. Longevity is one of fresco's virtues, but the possibilities of color are different than any other medium. The painter discovered that if he worked very quickly and placed one thin coat over another, he could achieve glowing transparencies. Until this restoration, Michelangelo was considered to be a great sculptor with a dark palette. Near the end of the work, the artist became even more daring. He mixed color with light and shadow. Color became drama. Other discoveries. Later restorers touched up the original work, not with fresco wet paint into wet plaster, but by painting directly on a dry wall. That eyelash, for example. If it were fresco, the cleaning fluid wouldn't pick it up. If it were dry, secco, the solution would remove it. Carefully, over time, the cleaning fluid is applied. A later painter had put dry paint over Michelangelo's work. There was criticism that the restorers were taking away not just the dirt, but also some of the original work. Chips of paint were taken from the wall. They were sent to a laboratory. The paint samples were put into gelatin, sliced thinly, put under the microscope and through chemical analysis. Michelangelo worked with only 9 pigments. Later retouchers used clearly different pigments. It's possible that a small amount of the master's dry brushstrokes had been picked up in the cleaning.
Yeah, and io lascerei altri 5 minuti sarebbero passati.